As you can see, he is going to be very important to foreign affairs. As you can see to your left, there's some books that were owned by George Marshall.
International affairs impact.
This is a painting of General George C. Marshall. As you will see, he's incredibly important to foreign affairs. Now we're going to move on into the next room if you'll follow me.
The Charter of the United Nations reflects these concepts and expressly provides for the promotion and protection of the rights of man as well as for the rights of nations. Approved by an overwhelming majority, the Declaration of Human Rights is a standard of conduct for all. And let us, as members of the United Nations, conscious of our own shortcomings and imperfections, join our effort in good faith to live up to this high standard. Through the United Nations, we are seeking to combine our efforts to promote international trade, to solve the difficulties of foreign exchange, to facilitate the voluntary migration of peoples, and to increase the flow of information and ideas across national boundaries. We, the people of the United Nations, says the Charter, are determined to save succeeding generations from the scourge of war, for these ends, to practice tolerance, and to live together in peace with one another as good neighbors. 3 years later, we are confronted with the need to save not only succeeding generations, but our own. The first purpose of the United Nations is to maintain international peace and security. And to that end, all members are pledged to settle their international disputes by peaceful means and in conformity with the principles of justice and international law.
Bist du okay?
I'm okay. Let's go meet the others.